Welcome back to the third and final video in our Livescribe Echo Smartpen Training series. In this video, we will show you how to use the Livescribe Echo desktop software to upload your notes from your pen to your computer. Echo desktop software allows you to save and categorize all your notes and share them online. When you're ready to download the Livescribe Echo software, go to www.livescribe.com. You can search for the Echo desktop software download using your preferred search engine, or simply follow the link provided on screen. Once you have reached the download page, you will see two download options, one for PC and one for macOS. Select the download that matches your computer's operating system. We will be demonstrating the PC version in this video. When the software is finished installing, you will find the Echo Desktop launch icon on your desktop. To start the Livescribe Echo Desktop software, double-click on the shortcut on your desktop. Make sure you have connected your Livescribe Echo Pen to the USB jack on your computer. If this is the first time you have connected your DPRC-issued SmartPen, upon detecting the pen, you will be prompted to provide a new name. You may name the pen whatever you like. Click Remind Me Later when asked to register. You may register if you like, but it is not required. Once your notebooks have been loaded to the Livescribe software, you will see them listed on the left under Active Notebooks. If you like, you may choose to rename them. This is useful if you're using unique notebooks for individual subjects. You may also create your own custom digital notebooks within the Livescribe software. This allows you to select pages from one or more notebooks and combine them into a named group, like a music playlist. This is a convenient way to organize similar content. Click File, then click Custom Notebooks, then Create. Name it whatever you like. Once you've provided a name, click OK. Your custom notebook will appear in the Library pane under Custom Notebooks. To add pages to the custom notebook, simply click and drag. Click on the custom notebook to see the pages you've added. All the notes you take with your SmartPen are digitized and stored in the Livescribe software. You may browse your notes by selecting a notebook and clicking on the page you would like to view. The notes and the audio are synced, just as with your SmartPen. When you click on a note in the Livescribe software, the audio recorded at that time will be played back. Located at the bottom of the screen are buttons used to control the audio playback of your notes. Clicking the Skip Forward and Skip Backward buttons will jump the audio playback 10 seconds forward and 10 seconds backward, respectively. In the bottom right corner of the screen is an audio playback speed controller. Move it toward fast to increase the playback speed. Now move it toward slow to decrease the playback speed. At the top right corner of the screen is the zoom in, zoom out slider. Click and hold the button with your mouse and slide it right to zoom in. Slide it left to zoom out. At the top right corner of the screen is a search field. Use this search field to search for words in your notes. When you have finished using a Livescribe notebook, you must archive it before using a new notebook of the same number. This will delete all the notes from your pen for that numbered notebook and save them to your computer. Your pen must be plugged in for your computer to proceed. The Livescribe software allows you to access both the pages of your notes as well as the audio session. If you want to view all the audio sessions individually, click on the Audio tab at the top left corner of the screen. If an audio session has notes associated with it, you will see a small paper icon to the left of the session name. Right-click on the session row and select View Pages. This will take you to the note page associated with that audio session. Not all audio sessions will have notes. This is up to you. You may rename a session if you have a meaningful name in mind. Right-click on the session and select Rename. If you need to remove an audio session from either your SmartPen or Echo desktop, you may do so by right-clicking on the row and selecting the respective option. Deleting audio from your pen could be especially useful if you are running low on space. Deleting an audio session from the pen will not remove it from the Echo desktop, and vice versa. The Echo desktop software allows you to export your notes into a handful of formats, like M4A audio and PDF. If you need to share or back up your notes in an open format, you can export them to your computer or send them via email. Right-click on the note you want to export and select Share. The Livescribe PDF option is a special type of PDF that includes your audio notes and allows you to click to hear them. However, they must be used in Livescribe's online viewer. Select Notes and Audio and click Continue. Create a name for your exported notes. Find the PDF file and open it. You will see your notes as they appear in the Echo desktop software. Notice, however, that when you click on them, you will be directed to livescribe.com. This is okay. Follow the link. When the page opens, you will be asked to upload the PDF you just created. Now when you click on your notes, you will hear the audio. Livescribe PDF files may also be imported back into Livescribe Echo Desktop and played like any other note. This concludes our three-part Livescribe Echo SmartPen training series. We hope the material covered was enough to get you up and running with your DPRC-issued Livescribe Echo SmartPen. If you have any questions about your pen or any other adaptive software that the DPRC offers, please come to the DPRC front desk in SSB 110 and ask for assistance. Thanks for watching.